What's happening, everybody? You saw the title. You see the box, a much smaller box than last month. Here is my February shipment from mycomicshop.com, full of goodies, pre-ordered back issues, variants, and just all-around dope comic book goodness. So let's crack this open with my adamantium blade here, and let's see where there's usually a flap. I know it should be this side, hopefully. Oh yeah, pretty devastated that box. That way off to how I normally do this. You got some packing material there, that there. So again, if you're new or newish, here's how they pack. These trusty little corner things protect the corners of our precious comic books. One bundle there. Two bundles. My trusty packing slip. The next DC Connect. So it's the next phase of the DC Universe starts here. Infinite Frontier, issue 8. I don't know why I call it issue. Nothing real, but content to it. January soliciting titles on sale starting March 2021. So you got there all the Infinite Frontier stuff. If you've been looking at that, and then there you go. Got that. Set that there. And then bundle number 3. Easy peasy, let's get to it. I don't know where we're gonna start. So, let's start with this one. Boom, let's do it. Oh yes. I remember some of the stuff that might have been in this. I know I tried to squeeze in some back issues, but I missed the cutoff for January's order, I think. For the fright for that shit. Trusty bag, save that one. All right. And as always, you get the first look of the first book. Boom. I'm going to guess it's a Marvel title, a long-standing character. I don't think it's a team book. I'm going to say it's a single character, solo character book. What is it? Oh, completely off. Kaiju Score number 3 from Aftershock Comics. And then you got some Future State action. Here is the Future State Dark Detective number 2. That should be is that Gabriel Dahados? I think so. Yeah, should be. Dark Detective. And here is Batman Superman number 1. Ben Oliver cover there. Excalibur 17. Excalibur. And then we got, where are we at? Department of Truth, like this one, like the coloring on that one, number 5. Department of Truth. Double D, number 26. This is the Verse Alien cover, or Alien Verse. I think it's Verse Alien cover there. Ooh, that'd be interesting. Xenon Marsh are tough, man. I don't know. Then we have Brave New World Part 4, Captain Marvel number 25. Yes. Yes, yes. Jorge Molina. Or George Molina? Jorge Molina? I don't know if he goes by George or Jorge. Here is the Batman Black and White number 2 cover featuring Catwoman. This is, I can't remember if it's, how do you pronounce her name? It's like Carmone Shirahama? Ah, I forgot. Sorry if I butchered your name, but fantastic artist. And she did a lot of covers for, well, not a lot, but she did several covers for Batgirl and the Birds of Prey. And I was like, whoa. She looks dope. And then I saw her name on this one. I was like, I have to get that one, obviously. And here is the, is this the jock cover for number 2 as well? The Batman Black and White. Made Spider-Man 58. I honestly don't care for that cover that much. It's okay. And we got the X-Force vs. Aliens cover here. Number 16. This one was cool. Nice shot. This reminds me of is it Uncanny X-Men? It's not 158, is it? But it's definitely kind of an, I feel like it's an homage to the X-Men vs. the Brood cover. I feel like it's 158, but it might be actually 160. I think it's 168, actually. And more Aftershock love. Here is We Live, number 4. And we got Boom Studios, Once and Future, number 15. That hit, a lot of people have been loving that one since it launched. More Aftershock, third Aftershock title. Miskatani, number 3. Like Aftershock and Vault, dude, they get a lot of love on me. Well, Aftershock, Vault, and Boom, I think, and probably, honestly, like, they had a damn good 2020. Just tons of love, tons of dope titles out there that people are just eating up. So, yeah, they're, like, publishers on the rise, and publishers I'm constantly looking after. Especially, obviously, I was talking about Boom for years, but definitely Aftershock and Vault, just the amount of titles that I pick up from them, and, like, they're going to get a lot of love and attention from me, so. And we have Iron Fist versus the Alien versus Alien cover. Iron Fist, Heart of the Dragon, there's number 1. Now, I do already have the, I picked up the David Aja cover, because I happened to go to the shop the week that this dropped. So, I have 2 of those. And here is New Mutants, number 15. Now, that's cool. And this next one might be one of my favorite of the versus Alien covers, Shang-Chi, number 5. Because just look at this. Everything about this is just awesome. Like, seriously, that's probably one of my favorite ones. More Boom Studios action. Something's Killing the Chosen, number 14. Oh, I love the green on this next cover, but I used to do that. So green is, if you've been reading Spawn for any amount of time, especially since the beginning, just like the coloring in, like the use of the color green throughout the entire runtime of this series, and especially once Francesco Martina started doing covers, and like just his use of green on this, it's just that neon green there, it looks fantastic. I love it. And yeah, another publisher here. Here is Mad Cave Studios, Stargazer, number 5. Go check this title out. Some sci-fi action there. And then this one should be Unkindness of Ravens, but I don't know what number. I think it should be 5, actually, from Boom Studios. So more Boom love here. So I got 4 on the last one. Ha, correct. So yes, Unkindness of Ravens, number 5, Boom Studios there. So more Boom love. I got several titles from Boom Studios, Aftershock. Now, I haven't seen Vault yet, no. But yeah, already several titles from both of those publishers. Oh my god, what was I gonna say? We Only Find Them When They're Dead, number 5. Another Boom Studios hit there. Taking these Dead God covers here. And someone you gotta see against the aliens, of course. Here is Wolverine, number 9. Ooh-wee. Wolverine, there's an alien. It'll be Wolverine versus Predator is gonna be the real, matchup. Here is X-Men versus Aliens, number 17. X-Men be able to hold their own for a while, but man, aliens are damn deadly, man. Especially you get the queen in there. Woo-wee, let me tell you. Here is, this should be actually one of the last of the Alex Ross timeless covers. Here is Hawkeye. This is Avengers 42. And I also have the Black History Month cover featuring Blade by, who's the artist on this one? It was like something Sousa. I never seen his work before, but I have several of his Black History Month variants in, probably in here. I know I ordered several of them. And the next 4 are all variants of the same title from Image. Here is Deep Beyond, number 1. This is, was this the standard cover by Ricardo? I think so, yeah. And then this one is, wait, let me see. So those ones, and then this one should be, this one's the Mark Randolfo variant there. And then we got Peach Momoko, but not just the standard one. Also have her sketch one as well. So definitely went in deep with Deep Beyond. Deep Beyond number 1. Boom. Bundle number 1. Down. On to bundle number 2. Dude, this ever so genuine. We're gonna salvage the bags. Always can reuse your materials. Especially like packing and shipping materials. Like easily just reuse them because it saves on everybody. right, and you get the reveal because that's what I do for the people. Boom, this one is, I'm gonna say a DC title. It is, I don't know. Oh, off again. But, oh, this is actually, where are the rest of them? I don't know. But I ordered this one because I wanted this covers. But this is Spawn 312. This is the creator's cover. So it does have, like, the skyline is reminiscent of Amazing Spider-Man. And this one has all the creators. This is actually what the one I anticipated, or I hoped, or I thought the local comic shop day book was going to be, but that one was actually just one representing for the local comic shop. So, oh, well, I still want the creators cover, so I got this one. This is actually the virgin one, so no title there, but I do have the one with the title on it, and it is in green. I wanted both of them anyway, so you'll see that one at some point in here. Here is X Factor number 7. And Sea of Sorrows, number 3 from IDW. Oh, this is new. I don't remember. Oh. So here's another series I'm trying out. This is from Aftershock. Here is Maniac of New York. I almost forgot about this one. And I'm trying to remember. I don't even remember exactly what it's about, but it sounded good enough because obviously I ordered it, or I pre-ordered it. So yeah, I'm looking forward to checking that out. And then here is The Legend of Shang-Chi, number 1. So Shang-Chi getting a lot of love, long ahead of his movie, his on-screen debut. And this one features Lady Deathstrike, so that'd be interesting. Shang-Chi versus Lady Deathstrike, looking forward to seeing that one. King in Black, Return of the Valkyries, number 2. Return of the Valkyries. And King in Black, Marauders, number 1. This is the variant there. Marauders. And then King in Black, Gwenom vs. Carnage, number 2. Got that variant. And then should have the standard cover, yes. And then here's the standard cover as well. Had a good bow, just because. Let's look at that. And my man, Dane Whitman. That's right, baby. King in Black, Black Knight. Yes, he's back. Dane Whitman, Ebony Blade. Hoo-wee. Glad to see my man back. Popping up here, and he's gonna have a is it gonna be mini series? I don't think it's gonna be ongoing, but he should have or his new series should be dropping within the next couple months. I think I actually just pre-ordered those, so the number 1 of those anyway. Oh my goodness, look at this. Hellions number 9, look at that cover there, that's cool. Infinite Mirror action going on. Jenny Frison variant, Future State Wonder Woman number 2. I need to get that. Always down for some Jenny Frison art. Ooh. I don't remember this. I didn't even know there was a... Did I know there was a 3? Yes, I did. I forgot this was going 4 issues. But Future State, the next Batman, number 3. Honestly, I don't remember even seeing this cover. I think I was... I don't know who the artist is. Oh, wait. Is this Art Germ? I think that's why. And I hadn't even seen it yet. But look... Yeah, that's definitely Art Germ, isn't it? I don't see his tag, though. Oh, wait. Yep, there it is. Art Germ. And then we have Future State Flash, number 2. Oh, yes. Yasmin Putri. Just chef's kiss to anything she does. She is a phenomenal artist. Here is Far Sector, number 10. Look at this. That is one glorious piece of art right there. Keep doing you, Yas. And then here is Spawn 310. That's another issue that I wanted with Ninja Spawn on the cover there, just because this looks cool. So I got it. Get all the weapons. Oh my goodness. And then here's the standard cover of that one. Spawn 312, the full title, issue number there, and the green font on Spawn, which is perfect. All the creators on here. So many. So many people. Gosh. And then this is the tattoo variant for King in Black number 1. There were 4 of these that I wanted, and I just couldn't not get them all. So now I have them all, and that just looks cool. And, oh yeah, a couple issues I was, ooh, yes. Some other issues that I missed and couldn't find in stores. Here we go, representing for Mockingbird. This is a book I've been after for a while. Just Mockingbird Shield, 50th anniversary, number 1. Just a little one shot. Starring Mockingbird there, Payne Jones and Rosenberg. in this issue, the thrilling debut of the Red Widow. And then Symbiote Spider-Man, King in Black, yeah, whatever. Number three, this is the Torrin, I think it's, what's this, Torrin Clark, I think, is the artist name on this one. It just looks dope as hell. Symbiote action there. Then the Anhyuk Lee, Symbiote Spider-Man Marvel Tales. I just want, like, this cover and reprint some Symbiote Spider-Man stories there. I think, like, I think 257 to 259, maybe? I could be wrong. I know there's a few issues in there reprinted, so that was just a nice piece I had to have. And this one, finally, Terry Dodson, Terry and Rachel Dodson. Wait, no, actually, I think it's Ryan Sook. Yeah, this is Ryan Sook, but Justin Palmiotti, or Jimmy Palmiotti, Justin Gray, I don't know who Andrew Sosky is, but Countdown, Search for Ray Palmer, Superwoman, Batwoman. After this one for a while, it just looks dope. I'm curious to see what the hell is even going on in there. And then here she is again, that Carmen. This is an example. Was talking about Batgirl and the Birds of Prey, number 14. This is a variant that she did. So you kind of see. Oh, just look at this. This looks so dope. So shout out to her. Ooh, there they are. And then some more. You got some Hellcat action in here. You got tons of Femme Fatales in here. You saw some Mockingbird. We got some the Birds of Prey. Here is Patsy Walker Hellcat number 4 from her 5-issue miniseries. This is cool with Catherine Immonen, David LaFuente, and I don't know who Rauch is. Steven? I mean, I just made that up. And then got some Scotty Young action. We got Spider-Woman here. Some books I forgot which one's the newest one. I think this is the older one. One I wanted some years ago. Yeah, 2014, so her 5th series. This one, she's hanging upside down with a weapon in the background. This one, I remember seeing this one a few years ago, just never was able to get it, and then finally came in stock. So I snatched it up along with this one. Is that in my bag? That is. This is from the current series here with the red background there. Just had to get it. It looked dope. So shout out to Scotty Young. And then here's that crazy issue from Image Comics, Solid Blood number 17, Robert Kirkman and Ryan Ollie. I was like, all right, you know, let me find an issue and track it down and order it. But here it is. So we'll see what the hell's going on. It was just, go check out Robert Kirkman's video on this one on YouTube, and it's just kind of funny, just everything going on behind it. All right, we'll get to those two issues last. But first, next up, here is Olivier Coipel's cover for Batman 37. Another one I've been after for a while, finally popped up on my want list. So as soon as it did, I snatched it up. So, boom. Now, last two books in this run were actually two I was eyeing for in my last Amazing Spider-Man haul, like the eBay haul I had not too long ago. I showed off, it was all Amazing Spider-Man books. These two issues, I was about to get them, but the price started going, like the price shot up on. I was like, wait, that seems a little bit high for these two issues. And I was like checking mycomicshop.com, and then they had the same issues. I was like, oh, let me compare like the prices and the conditions. And certain ones, they actually don't do generic images. They will have the full scans, so you can actually scan in on them and look at them. And I was like, oh, you know, I was comparing the wraps and the edges and everything. I was like, you know what? Like, they're cheaper, the conditions look way better. So, like, the prices on those on the auctions shot up. So I was like, let me get them on mycomicshop.com. And I think at the time there was, they were included in the discount code for that week. So I was like, oh, you know what? This universe is saying pick them up. So I did. So we have, if the lizard doesn't get you insect, the Stagron will. It's a holiday holocaust. We call it the War of the Reptile Man, and Spidey is caught in the middle. Amazing Spider-Man 166. Yes, more 160s action there. Spidey. Look at that. And then, caught between the murderous might of the Spider Slayer and the startling power of Marvel's most shocking new superstar. Looks like it's going to be one of those days. Amazing Spider-Man 167. Yes, sir. Spider-Man. Yes. All right. And now for the stunning conclusion to the trilogy of bundles. Here is bundle number 3. And where's the top? This all is coming to an end. That's easy peasy. Easy peasy, comic squeezy. Oh, not so much. Never mind. Tape got caught. And so one of the books. Oh my gosh. Tape. Let go of your stranglehold on my comics. Alright, we get to reveal this book. Going to go back to, it's a Marvel book. So I tried to, I think the other two were indies. Yes, they were. Boom, right, we got Marvel, we got Marauders, number 17. And here is, the King in Black Thunderbolts, number 1. So we got Thunderbolts back in action, Taskmaster, Star, Kingpin apparently, Rhino, and there's a couple other characters. And then, here is King in Black, Gwinnom vs. Carnage, number 1. This is the Ryan Brown cover here. That was the one I pre-ordered, and then I picked up copies of the standard cover by, I think, Ken Lashley did those ones. And then here's my girl, Future State, Kara Zor-El, Superwoman, number 1. Honestly, I didn't care for either cover that much, so I just kind of just chose this one. And not only like her costume looks kind of goofy too, but yeah, I wish they would have had just something better for the art on those, the cover art. And then here we go, Future State, Justice League, number 1, the League, and then Green Lantern, number 1. This is not Jamal Campbell, is it? I don't know who did this one, but I like it. That's why I ordered it. And here is Dark Detective, number 1. Also featuring Grifters. Oh yeah, I like the blue. And then Vault Comics, finally. I feel like I didn't see Vault. Oh, I guess they're all in here somewhere. Devil's Red Bride, number 4. Vault. Bleed and Dry, number 6. So the finale to this miniseries. Ninja Vampire Tale. And which number is this? The Autumnal, number 4. So the, oh, where's all my vault? And here it is, all together, hanging out. Amazing Spider-Man 57. Spider-Man. Origins, number 3 from Boom Studios. I haven't even started reading that one yet. Sword, number 2. I still need number 1. Because I missed that one. And I forgot about it last time I was at a shop. So I have to snag that one at some point. American Ronin, number 4. AWA Studios. Artists, Writers, and Artisans. Dig it. Black Panther vs. Alien and the Avengers, number 41 variant. And then DC Black Label, Batman Catwoman, number 2, the Jim Lee Scott Williams cover. I'm going with the Jim Lee Scott Williams covers for these ones, as long as they keep doing them. And then Black Cat, number 2, King in Black. This is the standard cover. Oof. Yeah, all these covers for number 2 were fantastic. And then here's another Peach Momoko cover for number 2. So I have 2 of each of these except for the standard cover. I should have just grabbed another one when I was at the shop, but I didn't. Then this is our germ cover. Future State Catwoman number 1 in a new costume there. And then Peach Momoko, Immortal Wonder Woman number 1. And this should be Nicola Scott, I think. Nicola. I like the blue on this one though. Especially with the costume. This is probably one of my favorite Future State covers. Nightwing, number 1. And I think this one is... this Martina? And the last book, Future State, the next Batman, number 2. I think this should be Martina, Francesco Martina, perhaps. So that brings my February My Comic Shop shipment order haul, whatever you want to call it, to a close. Tons of cool stuff there. Tons of dope stories, some books that missed the cutoff, so they didn't quite make it to my already massive January order. There's other bundle there. And boom, paired of course by some Amazing Spider-Man back issue action. So that's dope. Going back, was that 77, so that was right. Wait, what? But they're only issue apart, huh? And it says April, March, April, I don't understand this. But yeah, so it's a solid book. It's a Scotty Young variants there. Carmen got the Spawn covers that I was eyeing. Plenty of Aftershock and Vault and Boom Studios love in here. And obviously Image, because you're going to see a lot of Image with me. And all those other publishers as well. So a lot of publishers in here getting some love. Of course, from Geno Dragon and my varied reading taste. So yeah, plenty of dope stuff here. And that means plenty of more stuff for me to log in and new reading material. So yeah, all types of good comic book goodness here. Let me know what you got on deck for reading, for collecting. What are you hunting? You picking up? Do you use any pre-order services like mycomicshop.com, Midtown, DCBS, or whatever else? There's plenty of services out there. What have you picked up lately? All that cool stuff. Any cool reads? Like what's going to your bookshelf? Whatever. Single issues, trades. You read digital? Whatever. Let's share. Have some fun. Plenty of dope stuff. So yeah. Happy reading, happy hunting, happy collecting. This is Geno Dragon. Thanks for watching and peace out.